Hey guys, how's it going? I felt like making another video, so I thought I would do a DVD update of some more recent pickups. Haven't had a chance to show these in any of my videos yet, so I thought I would do that now. Also going to do a quick review at the end of this update. But first, before I get started, I just want to say congratulations again to the winners of my DVD giveaway contest. You guys did a great job with your video responses, and to everyone who participated in my film still challenge as well. You know, you guys did a really great job. I know it was hard, but you know, you guys did very well. But thank you guys, I really truly appreciate it. You know, you subscribers, I appreciate all your support. If it wasn't for you guys, you know, I'd have no reason to be making these videos. It's because you guys watch them and comment that I continue to make them. So I truly, truly appreciate it. And thanks again, and as I said, congratulations to the winners. I've spoken with two of you now, just waiting on one of you to give me your shipping information, and then I can get those prizes shipped out to you guys. But again, thank you guys, thank you to all of my subscribers, for everyone who participated. And even for you, for those of you who didn't participate in the contest, I appreciate you being a subscriber, and I thank you for watching my videos and commenting from time to time. But anyway, getting into the update, picked up this 4-film pack recently. Contains 4 great movies here. We got Drive Through, Boy Eats Girl, Tamara, and Creep. And yes, it is called Tamara. You know, that's how they pronounce the name in the movie. So I know a lot of people call it Tamara, but according to the movie, it's Tamara, I guess. But anyway, you know, I say 4 great movies. You know, in my mind, they're 4 great movies. And they're cheesy B-movie types, but definitely the type of horror film that I enjoy. You know, I particularly bought this for Drive Thru and Boy Eats Girl. I've been wanting Drive Thru for a while now. It's one DVD that I don't own, and I don't know why. And Boy Eats Girl, I've wanted to see for a while as well. I've never seen this. Heard good things. I have seen Tamara. I saw it one time on a movie channel, I believe. And I enjoyed it. Thought it was well done. You know, kind of has a Carrie-like storyline, but you know, definitely different than Carrie. And Creep, I've actually read some mixed reviews, but you know, for the good reviews that I read, it definitely sounded like something I might be interested in checking out. So happy to have this now. 4 films on 2 discs. They are flipper discs, unfortunately, but I got this for $2.99. So that's a pretty good deal for 4 movies, I think. So definitely cool. Also picked up The Sandlot double feature. Contains The Sandlot and The Sandlot 2. Again, another movie I'm not sure why I don't own already, and that's, you know, the original Sandlot. I mean, just absolute classic. Who doesn't like The Sandlot? Amazing film. Got this, you know, with The Sandlot 2 in the double feature because it was $7.50. Could have gotten The Sandlot alone for $5, but I figure, you know, for the extra $2.50, get the second film, which I've never seen, but it is by the same director, and, you know, it kind of goes along with the same storyline, so I guess it'll be worth checking out. I know it definitely doesn't compete with the first one, you know, based on reviews and everything, and plus the first one being such a classic in my mind. But definitely glad to have this now. Also, something I did a review for recently, and it's Drive. I showed you guys the Blu-ray, and you know, that's what I had watched and everything. Had wanted to get, you know, this movie on DVD as well, just because, you know, movies that I really like, I like to get on all formats that I can. And I really, really love this movie. I mean, this is, you know, this is definitely one of my top films now. I absolutely love this. I've actually watched it a second time now since that review, and just absolutely blew me away again. Just great, great film. But went to get this on DVD, and actually at one of my local stores, it was a store exclusive. And, you know, it's one of the smaller stores. It's not like a big name store or anything. But every now and then they do have certain exclusives. And it was a combo pack exclusive for their store. You know, there's nothing too special about it, except for the fact that it comes with both the DVD and the Blu-ray, and it comes in, you know, a clear plastic case rather than the black case that the normal DVD release comes in. But still cool enough. You know, I got another copy of the Blu-ray in here, as well as the DVD, which I had wanted. So that's cool to have as well. And then next, I got this, and that's Schindler's List. This is that giant set. You know, I had wanted this for a while. I remember back when this first came out, it was very expensive, so I never got it back then. You know, Schindler's List is a movie I've probably seen maybe once or twice, and you know, it's a great film, don't get me wrong. It's just not something I would, you know, normally watch. You know, I'm not gonna, it's not the type of movie I'm gonna, you know, be at home on a Friday night thinking, gee, I feel like watching Schindler's List. As I said, that has nothing to do with the film itself. It's, you know, it's definitely a brilliant film, but, you know, I'd rather watch a horror film. I'd rather watch someone get slashed and stuff, or, you know, a comedy, something like that. But still a film worth having. I haven't owned it in my collection up until now. So I saw this. This was used, obviously, and it was $10, I believe. $10, $11, something like that. And definitely worth it. It was used. I picked it up. You know, it looked pretty good. I did notice, you know, when I got home that, you know, it was a little cracked right there. It's missing a piece. But, you know, what are you going to do? This is out of print now, and I know it's hard to find. And as I said, it looks up nice up on the shelf. It's going to be standing like this anyway. You can't really notice, you know, the broken part. What I'm going to do now is open it up for you guys, show you what's inside. So it'll be I opened it up, and now as you see, you got all these different pieces. Here's the case, the cover that goes over it, just clear plastic. You know, sturdy plastic, of course, hard. Definitely breakable, which is why it was a little cracked. This is the back. It has all the names, which I think is really cool. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it does have all the names, all numbered. Very, very cool. I really like that aspect of it. Then you have, you know, the good stuff here, which I'll get to in a minute. This is kind of a slipcase that went over all the good stuff. And then you have the back. Just tells you what's included in the set. But as for the good stuff, you come right here. It opens up. It's kind of like a digibook style of the DVDs. You open up. There you go. You get a flipper disc, which kind of sucks. But, you know, it's alright. There's a few slight scratches on it, I noticed, too. As I said, I did buy this used. You know, nothing that's going to trigger, you know, playback issues or anything like that. But still to the point where it's probably going to bother me, so I'll end up getting, you know, a standalone copy of the movie just to trade it out with this disc and get rid of this one and keep the new disc in there. This is the soundtrack right here. And then you got a booklet in here. But definitely a nice packaging. I like how it's packaged. Pretty cool. Then we have the film cell there of this image, as you can see. That's cool as well. It's number 8,603. I'm not sure how many of these there actually were. And you have the certificate of authenticity. Always cool to have. And then finally you have this book, images of Steven Spielberg's film, Schindler's List. Got a foreword by Steven Spielberg and photographs by David James. The back of it says, "Whoever saves one life saves the world entire." Pretty nice quote. You see, go in, just got some images and all that stuff. So that's very cool as well. So definitely a nice set. Pretty cool to have. As I said, it looks nice up on the shelf. Now I'm going to get into my review of the horror film. Another recent pickup, I guess you could say. Got this in the mail and ordered it through the site, obviously. And you guys have seen this many times now. I know a lot of other YouTubers have reviewed it. But it is the Orphan Killer, for those of you who don't recognize it. You see there's the back there. I did go for the signed copy, as you can see. So that's pretty cool. Signed by the director and the two stars of the film. Very cool. You know, I figured if I was going to order it, I might as well order the signed copy. Got a chance to watch this, actually, the night that I received it in the mail. I've been wanting to do a review of it, but just haven't gotten around to it. I've been doing other videos, as you guys know. Comes with this little insert. Full Fathom 5 Productions LLC, and it says "Have a Bloody Day" on the back, so that's cool. Then you have the two discs, you got the movie, and then you have the soundtrack. So that's very cool. The soundtrack does contain that song, you know, made famous by the Lost Boys, so I definitely noticed that right away. It's a, you know, obviously a different version, a cover of it, but still very cool, recognizable, you know, brings you into that horror mood, because the Lost Boys is definitely a favorite of mine, one of my favorite vampire flicks. But as for this movie, I mean, I really liked it. You know, for an independent, you know, low-budget film, I really enjoyed it. The gore was amazing in this film. I mean, I really liked the kill scenes. You know, the deaths were really creative. You know, it wasn't just someone just basically getting stabbed. There was a lot more to it. I mean, you know, this guy can really swing an axe and, you know, whatever weapon he's using. It's just really good stuff. You get a lot of blood spraying everywhere. You get a lot of great sounds and crunching sounds and slicing sounds and cutting sounds and all that, so... You know, definitely good for gore hounds and people who love, you know, violence in horror films, basically. You know, it's not your typical suspense type horror. It's not Halloween in that sense where, you know, people are getting stalked. I mean, this guy is just out for blood, and it's pretty cool. Like, as I said, if it's your kind of thing, then this is definitely a movie worth checking out. So as I said, for you gore hounds, this is definitely something you guys should get a hold of. Really cool. You know, I've seen mostly good reviews about it. I've seen a few negative reviews, and the negative reviews saying that, you know, a lot of it happens too soon. You know, he kills people, you know, like, way too fast. But that's actually one thing that I liked about it. You know, it started really, really fast. I mean, before you even have a chance to realize what's going on, people are getting hacked up left and right. And I kind of enjoyed that. And then, you know, the people giving the negative reviews said because of that, you know, the last, you know, half or so gets a little slow. But I don't think so at all. I think that's what makes this movie stand out, is that was the point. You know, that's what makes it not your typical slasher film. You know, most of these typical slasher films, you know, we're used to, you know, the build-up in the beginning of what's going to happen. You maybe have one or two kills here and there, and then you have, like, this huge climax of all the killings. That's when all the killings are happening. Whereas with this one, you know, he kills all the people that really don't matter first, you know, without going too much into the storyline. I mean, there's really one person he's after. And once he kills everybody that would get in his way, you know, he's just left with this one person to deal with. And that's where the real story comes in, and that's the point of this film, which, as I said, I think makes it stand out from other slasher films. Also, in the negative reviews, people have said that they thought the ending was predictable. To an extent, yes, but then there's also that last scene that I think was thrown in there that was a nice touch. You know, it's nothing that's completely original or completely new, but it was definitely a nice touch, and for this film, you know, I really didn't expect that to happen, like, exactly what happened. You know, I expected maybe someone to come back and jump out, like a jump-out scene, almost like that the Carrie hand coming out of the grave scene or something like that. You know, I thought there would be some type of shocking moment at the end. But the way it was done, I think, was a little unique and definitely cool. So I really enjoyed that, you know, with the package, for those of you who have seen it. You know, I don't want to give too much away and spoil anything, but I think I can say that without spoiling anything too much. But yeah, I really enjoyed that. Really enjoyed the movie, and I would definitely recommend it. Glad I ordered a copy. And very cool. Also want to thank Andrew Bellina, again. He's a good friend of mine here on YouTube. He recommended this to me, and you know, I watched his review on it, and that's what really, you know, made me decide that I wanted to see this movie. I watched his review, and I knew that I had to have this. And you know, he also talked to me recently and asked me to do a review of it. So here's my review, Andrew, and I hope you approve. So that's it for now, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, congratulations to the winners of my contest, and I'll be back soon with some more videos, guys. Comment, subscribe. I appreciate it. Thanks.